the rockets up in space, the top part of the rocket will separate, and then M2, which is one of the many satellites on this mission, will be ejected out of the rocket and enter orbit around the Earth. We'll start off as one connected satellite approximately 3 months after being up in space, and once it's been completely tested and we know it's working as it's meant to, it'll then separate into two separate satellites. And this allows us to conduct, I guess, a lot of research from the separation itself, and we'll then be able to conduct formation flying, so the satellites will fly together.
Why fly in formation? There's a number of reasons for that. One of the reasons is that it means you can test inter-satellite communication links, and we will be attempting to do that and demonstrate on that mission. You can test the understanding of the way that these spacecraft interact with the environment up there, and that's very, very important. You can use one as the control and use the other as an experiment and test the difference depending on what you're doing.
We've designed all of our software so that we don't actually need to be in kind of the typical control room that you might imagine kind of at NASA, mission control room where you've got lots of different computers. We have a web-based software that we use for operations.
A previous role of mine in Air Force was a flying maritime patrol aircraft, and we used to surveil large areas of ocean and look for any ships within that area of ocean. So what the M2 satellite we'll be testing for potential future capability is looking at the whole Earth and being able to detect a large number of ships in a much smaller amount of time than an aircraft can. And what that does for us is it allows aircraft to focus on more important missions and cut down time and focus on a particular area if we need to. This is really a pivotal moment for space in Australia, and what a project such as M2 does is it allows industry to grow, it allows academia to grow, to the point that when defence needs a large space-based project, there's an industry base that's there ready to go with the experience needed to build these large and complex missions.
It's an amazing part of our space program because it's really demonstrating our sovereign capability, you know, Australia's capability to build those satellites and then test them in space. So it's all about being able to test our surveillance capabilities from the ground, but also the fact that we built these satellites in Australia, launched them, and are now controlling them from Australia.